Advanced Project made a cool thing, but let's start with the base figure because, wow, oh boy, this thing is quite sick. So this is Classics Prime. I'm not going to spend too much time on this guy because it's a figure that's been out since 2006-ish and was talked about to death during that time and still is now. So this specific upgrade has something super cool, so make sure you stick around to the end to hear about it because I will talk about it in more detail once I get to the actual armor section. But I really like this base figure. The plastic is super solid. There is clear plastic in really stupid areas, which I don't get, but that's just something to watch out for. It feels really strong and sturdy, but I have heard reports about people breaking it. But then again, those reports came out fairly recently and this figure is from 2006, so it does hold up. As a whole, it looks really cool. I do like this a lot more than the Earthrise Prime, but that is just me. The doors on the arm, yeah, they're weird, but I don't mind. I just pretend they're shields and move on. The look of this figure is super nostalgic to me. It's in the looks department because I never had one when I was little, but I would see it everywhere. TFCon, Toys R Us, they would just be all over the place. I just never ended up getting one. Now that I have the chance to get one, it's super, super cool. The plastic is super dense and solid, as I said, but it's not something you pick up on until you actually hold it next to a modern figure like this Earthrise Prime mold. And yeah, the Earthrise Prime is a great mold, but the plastic is just, it feels okay, and then you hold it next to Classics Prime, and you feel how thin and flaky the modern day equivalent is. It's just, it's a brick, this new one. It's so, like, it feels so nice in the hand, the plastic. It's chunky, blocky, and a lot of what I wanted in a Prime like this, and it just works. Posing though, by modern standards, is meh. It poses, it like, it has all the basics, but it is missing the modern points like ankle pivots, wrist swivels, but for the time this came out, it did a very good job. And I still think it does a pretty decent job nowadays. This was a used copy, so it is missing the SMG looking smokestack gun thing, but I did get the wind scoop, wind vane top part piece. I don't know what it's called. I don't know, truck bits. But it turns into a really big gun. That is a great use of parts forming. Speaking of forming, transformation is actually quite satisfying. And the fact that the weapons store on the vehicle, the way that they do it is so clever because it actually becomes part of the truck smokestacks and the wind scoopy bit. It's just, I love how this figure works. Truck mode is it's a truck. I mean, it's Optimus Prime. He always turns into nine times out of 10, he turns into a truck. There isn't much to say about that other than this truck looks damn good. I like how it's a different take on the flat-nosed truck. Kind of reminds me a lot of Age of Extinction Galvatron, and I will get more onto that in a little bit as well. He is a good size though. Like, the truck scales mostly with modern day stuff, which is really nice. It's a really nice unintentional detail. Now to make him bigger. Fans Project started with upgrades and made one hell of an upgrade here. You have to remove the hands, that's an amendment that's in the instructions because it wasn't part of the original, and unscrew the shoulders for this guy, but all the screws are reused, so you don't have to worry about extra bits lying around. Once this is said and done, whoa, Power Master Prime here looks sick. Yes, this is a heavy homage to Power Master Optimus Prime, and it works. The proportions aren't for everyone, I will say that, but I do really like it. It did take me a while to get used to the really long legs, but once I got it in hand, it actually wasn't that bad. The blues don't match, I will say that. The blues do not match, but the contrast between the two blues isn't the worst. It's broken up quite well that it looks normal. The instructions do show the Henkei version, so I'm assuming the blues on the Henkei version might be closer to the Fans Project upgrade kit than the standard release, but it still looks nice overall. He is also really big now. And the posing does get slightly better too, with opening hands, more wrist articulation, and ankle pivots. They added ankle pivots. Now you can get him into really cool dynamic poses. I keep saying it's nice, and that's because it is. The plastic feels different from the core figure, but not in a bad way. It still feels super strong and robust. Just with most upgrade kits, try not to remove this as much because you can risk breaking tabs and like bits off, because most upgrade kits of the time and a lot now are meant to go on and stay on. Now let's do truck mode. There are a couple of new steps and some panels that weren't in the instructions but are in the amendment. It's like a little gray sheet you get that says, hey, we added these bits, because the pre-release copies had like some issues, so they fixed those. That fills in the gaps in the truck mode, and it's super nice. It does kind of limit the swivel of the doors a bit when you're transforming it. They do kind of clash into each other, but it's not something that's super worrisome or annoying. But once it's all said and done, hello Age of Extinction Galvatron in prime colors. It looks a lot like the Freightliner Argosy, and I dig it. The hands are stupid. I'm gonna be honest. The hands are just, they look really stupid. I get what they're trying to be. They're trying to be those canisters that sit on the side of the truck, but they look like poo. But that's my only really complaint with how this truck looks. The smokestacks can be shifted up and down to your liking, and he has a trailer hitch. Don't know if it's compatible with any trailers, MP10s, Fans Projects, other two trailers, Dark of the Moon's trailer. I don't know. I don't know what it's compatible with, but it does look cool. The truck bed is so long, you can fit an entire Warpooth on the back. Like, it is that big. This truck is also really solid. And yes, I say get it, because here's the super cool thing that I mentioned at the beginning of this video. The armor only costs $15. That's it. $15 off BBTS, not sponsored. I'll link it below as usual so you can go and get one if you want. And if you don't have Classics Prime like me, you can just get a used incomplete one because you don't use the weapons at all. The original standard weapons just go off to the side. You can still put them on, but like, he has new like shotgun things. So you don't need the weapons. You could just get like a $10 or $15 incomplete figure. Like, this was $20. It's not going to be that expensive for something that is leader class sized and super fun to mess with. It's just, it's $15 for the upgrade kit. How can you say no to that? It's on sale, but like, it's been on sale for forever. So I highly recommend getting it before they're all gone if you have a Classics Prime, because it looks so nice in person. I'm super happy with this purchase, and yeah, I recommend it if you're into this style, because like I said, the proportions are odd and it's not for everyone. But that's been my look at Classics Prime with the Parallax armor. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.